behind the map.
Hello, everyone. Yeah, my name is Moses Kamau from East Africa. I am Scorers Award winner and probably the oldest in the room. I'm 21 years. And here it is. So, what is the power behind a map? And especially to the third world or the developing countries, most of them in sub-Saharan Africa. I come from Kenya, Kenyatta University. A member of GIS club in the school, we were the founders, and as a member of around 10 students, we decided that we need to do something. But what is this something, and how are we going to do it? This is the team seated with our machines, doing what we love doing, making maps. To the right hand side, is the whole team, and that left is our professor, who is our patron, who is really motivating to us as the group of students in what we usually do. But what holds us together, what anchors us together, is this one that I've just told you. It's the GIS craft, the Kenyatta University GIS craft. But we really need to come to have this, to have the things that we should hold, we should do, so that we can be together. So, why map? Why map? As you know, maps are perfect tools in solving various problems. For instance, in the map displayed there, it shows the situation of food security in Eastern African part. And if most of you are in the primary session, you might have heard Jack say about the presidential election maps. And after the results of the presidential election map, the current ruling government came up with four big agendas. And one of them, the fourth one, the last one was food security. So we need to help these governments in place to know where does this food insecurity exist. So such maps are powerful tools, and we really believe that if the governments adopt this, it's gonna really help them. That's another one. Also, we can adopt that one to show the areas that receive various amounts of rainfall, when, which month, and how they can use to help farmers and advise them in growing the crops. On the right-hand side is the African map, indicating areas where maize is grown, the temperatures, and as you understand, well, maybe you might not be getting it. In Africa, there is this pest which has grown. It is right there. It originated from the Americas, native to Americas, but it is causing nuisance to many crops in sub-Saharan Africa and causing a lot of billion dollar losses. But there is a problem. The governments, the response mechanism doesn't know where this pest is affecting the specific locations, and this is where we are working on, so that we can be able to inform them that this is the precise location where this infestation is occurring. This is the location where the infestation is happening, and you are supposed to go there so that you can provide the various measures to respond to it. This is the pest. It's an edited map showing where the pest originated. And there is a farmer who is dismayed. He's wondering what to do. But the government is now in a position to adopt this, and they will be able to respond to this pest causing nuisance. I'm calling it the wanted, the ravenous repair, but I know using the power in map to communicate and to spread this message, the precise location will be known, because location matters. And thank you very much.
Okay, next we have